Okay. So first of all, when you have you installed the Android Studio?
Yes.
Okay, great. To those who did not install the Android Studio, you can install later on, or maybe you have to wait until you return back to UMP, yeah. So you can use the lab computer. So first, you can click a file. Okay, let me introduce. Okay. First thing is you can create a new project here. Okay. In this project, okay, they provide several template. Okay. Empty activity. Okay. There is no activity. Basic activity, you can see here there is a button, a plus here, or button navigation activity, there are three button, okay, by default, okay, or this is empty, so means blank, yeah, and then full screen activity, Google AdMob, Google Map activity, okay, a login activity already designed by the template, okay, and many things, yeah. There are many many template that they provide, okay, but basically from if you want to start from the beginning, we start from the empty, okay, from the scratch. So then you click this one empty and click next. Here you can see that there is a name, package name, okay, and a save location, the file that you want to save, okay. Okay, for the name, for example, here you can type my application, or you can maintain like this, or you want to write your own name, your mobile app's name, yeah, for example, Shopee or maybe other thing. And save location, okay, well, let's say, for example, yeah, here I change into test. Can you see the package also follow the name? My first. Okay, and then save location. Okay, you can change the location as you want. Okay, based on your preference. Okay, now let me save it into Drive D. Okay, for the language, there are two type of language that you can use, and this is a different, yeah, Kotlin and Java. So you can choose a Java because I believe you familiar Java, okay, compared to Kotlin. Okay, so choose the Java file, the Java language, yeah, and the minimum SDK. You can see there are many SDK that they provide. So the minimum SDK here means when you want to create the mobile apps, you should choose the minimum Android SDK file. Okay, means the library that you want to use as a minimum standard, is the minimum one. So let's say here the minimum one is, for example, here is ice cream sandwich. So I choose the minimum one. Okay, you can see your application will be run on approximately 100 of devices around the world. So whatever the Android device, okay, phone, okay, Android phone, so they can install your application. Okay, compatible with your application 100%. What happen if you choose for example Oreo, this one, so there are only 60.8% of device or mobile phone compatible with your application. So you have to set up the minimum as you can so that your application can be installed all devices. Okay. Okay, then click finish. let me start from explanation from the top left corner here. If you look at the Android here, so means that you just created the Android file, okay? Usually they start with loading the Gradle file, and inside your file, inside the project here, it consists of manifest, Java file, and resources. Okay, for the manifest here, if you look at the manifest file XML, it show that the package, and your package, okay, and your label. Okay, usually when you open the Android, you can see the top left corner, which is the label name. So this is the main application. Let me change. Android. Before this is my first application, right? And they follow the your name, yeah. So let's say I change into my Android, the label of your application, okay. And then this is icon, so you can change the icon, okay. How to change the icon here? You can look at the resources here. Okay, click, and inside the resources there are drawable file, layout, meet map, and value. So you can store your image under drawable, okay, or meet map, okay, both. Okay, in order to, okay, next one is this is the theme, okay, we use the default theme, and the most important in the Android manifest is this one, okay. It show that your current class, okay, your current class, we start by .main main activity, okay. By default, okay, your application, your main class is entitled main activity, and then there is intent filter here, so. The action Android name, Android intent action main. Okay, so this is the main one. It show that this class as a main, as the first one, okay. And the second statement Android intent category launcher. So this is, it means that you give a trigger to the Android engine to launch main activity first. If you have a several class, okay, you can set, okay, for the first activity, or as the main activity is the class number 3, it possible, okay. So you just change this one, okay, into the other class. It means that once you open the Android, okay, it trigger to open the selected class. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here we have a main class. Sir, how do we check our class? You can go to the Java here and select com.example.myclass. You can see this is your class, main activity. By default, the name is main activity like this, huh? So it represent dot main activity, okay, you are appoint this Java file, okay, your class here, main activity. So means that in the manifest here, when you appoint this class, so means you ask Android to compute and calculate and build this class first, okay. So this is number one. Will be compiled. Okay, and basically in the Android Studio, they have open, save, okay, they have a back, and then they have a virtual, okay, this is virtual device as I explained before. Okay, if you don't have this one, okay, you can click open AVD, okay, and then you can create your virtual device, choose the phone, choose the pixel resolution, okay. Okay, if you don't have the proper one, maybe you can import the hardware profile. Okay, you can find it through you can Google and export then import here. Okay, after that click next. Okay, and here I suggest it to you to use Pi. Okay, Android 9.0. Okay, for the virtual device. Yeah, it's not different. Yeah. At the beginning, you choose the lowest Android because your application, the aims is you want to design and develop application for all devices and can be used for all devices. But for this one, this is the virtual device, okay? Not the Android version, okay? The virtual device, your mobile phone like this, okay? You set the into a certain version, yeah, Android version. Yeah. So here I recommend to you Android 9. Okay. So let's say I don't want to use Android 9. Okay, you can use this one. Okay. Cable data. Okay, you can plug in into your computer. Let me show it to you. Okay, just plug it like this. Okay. Let's say you don't want to use a virtual one. Let me close. Okay. Can you see here? And this is my phone. Xiaomi Mi A1. So I don't want to use the virtual one, but I want to use the real device. So how to make it? How? Because my phone ready set up here. If you have a phone now, you can open your phone, click setting. Okay. After that, scroll down. Choose the system, okay, and then you can find the developer option. Get it?
Yes.
Okay, choose the developer option, okay, click on and then scroll down. There is a debugging, USB debugging, okay, turn on that one, USB debugging or debug mode when USB is connected. That's it. Okay, so I can choose my real device or my virtual one. For example, I choose the virtual one, so I unplug my data. So what is benefit virtual and the real one? For the real one can be run faster compared than the virtual one. Okay, the virtual one, if you have if you want to run into the virtual device like this, usually it will give effect, your computer will be slower lah. Okay, and this is the run button. Okay, after you really complete everything, then you can run this one. If any changing, okay, you can use this one. You don't need to run start from the beginning, so you just run the changing part, okay, and it will be updated in order to update. Okay, I think that one is the most important part, and this is the AVD, same like here. Okay, AVD, create the virtual device. Okay, and then this is the SDK manager. Okay. So SDK manager here is it's also important, okay, especially you have to make sure the API level meet the standard, okay. You can choose the Android here, Pi. And then what else? Project structure, okay, run anything, okay. Okay, that one is a Java file. And another one is more important is the layout. Okay. Number one is suppose number one is layout, okay, from your front line, okay. Front screen, and then this is your Java file, okay, and follow the manifest. Manifest is the whole structure, okay. If you have more than one Java file, so it will be automatically updated here. This is activity number one. Okay. Maybe you will have 4, 5 activity. We call it activity, yeah, or classes, class, yeah. Then it automatically updated here. Then you can set who is the main class, who is the second class, third class, and so on. Okay, next is a drawable. Okay, drawable. If you open here, this is the usually we use it to store the images, okay, but we store it into the XML file. Usually we have JPEG or BMP or TIFF, okay? And it can be stored into the MIPMAP. And the next most important thing is the layout, okay. Once you click this one, you can see the layout. So this is your interface. In your layout, okay, you can see Hello World, right? Let me run. Okay, Gradle build running. If any error, they will show it through here. Build, you can see. Okay, still running. How many seconds? Okay, finish. Okay, can you see this is my label? My Android. Before this is my first application, but I changed my Android. I changed through manifest, the label one. Okay, before this my first application, isn't it? So I changed through my Android manifest to be my Android. And then this is the label. Okay, after that, this is the text that has been designed in the layout. Then it will be appear in this apps. So this is the output. Okay. Inside the virtual, there is a volume, okay, rotation, camera, and so on. Mostly not really necessary, okay. If you install into your phone, it can be. They have the same function, yeah. Okay, next one. Let me close it. Okay, minimize, yeah. Let me explain here. Here we have a palette. If you look at the palette here, there are common such as text view. So this is text view. Okay. So what is that, sir? This is the constraint layout. We call it constraint layout here. We have a button. We have image view. We have recycle view, and so on. Okay. Text, okay, button, image button. Image button. What is that, sir? The image can be a button. So you click the image and it triggers something. Okay, and checkbox, radio button, okay, switch. Another one is view, okay, image view, video view, calendar view, okay, progress bar, sig bar, and then rating bar, surface view. We also have a few you can explore after this. Okay, within next 3 weeks, we are going to explore all of these things. Okay, so you know how to use it. Yeah. Okay. Well, for today, I will ask you to delete this one first. So now empty. I want to design a text view here. I want to design a plain text. Plain text here is sometimes I can I prefer to call it edit text. So means that user can fill in this text, and then we also can edit it. Okay, we also can update. So we call it plain text. And then what else? Name, and maybe another text view here. Maybe I give you I give a button here. So once let's say I want to create application that I fill in something, I type something in the edit text here. Once I click the this button, and the result will be displayed here. For example, here I type my name, okay, and then when I click this button, it triggered to change this text. This text, the original text, is text view. All right. Later on, okay. If you look at here, the constraint layout, it will be trigger some error, right? You can see here the error. This view. This view is not constrained. It only has design position. So missing constraint in the constraint layout. When you design the mobile apps, you have to give a constraint layout. So you have to set the position, so the text not changing. The question is, let me delete this. What happened if I run the program without constraint layout? Usually it trigger an error. This is to stop. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I forgot to explain. Stop this one. Stop the application here. So it will be empty like this. What happened if you run the text? If you run the Android application, and when you design this one without constraint layout, so the position like this, I can be move anywhere like this. Try to run. You can see it can be proceed, okay, but you can see the result. I put in the middle, the result will be top left corner because you don't set the position. So something like what happened if you have more, for example, button here, I want to tag here. There are three, I want a position like this. Okay, I want a position like this, for example. No constraint layout. When you run, you can see. All the component, adding, renaming resources required the application restart. Okay, they want to restart. All component will be displayed on the top left corner. Here. Where is the text view, sir? Here. Behind the button. All the elements will be at the position 0, 0, 0. So how to design? This is the question. Huh? So I want to design like this. This is if you let me show it to you the wrong way first. Okay, then I will show it to you the correct way. Okay, let's say I want to design like this. Yeah? Because this is very important. Within one semester, you always use technique. Yeah? The simple way, you click this one. Okay, but this is the wrong one. Eh? Wrong. Sorry. Okay. This is the wrong way. Don't follow this, but I will show it to you. But it still can work. Yeah? Example, you click this one. And then you go to the properties. This is the properties. Okay. Okay. Go to the layout. Just do this one. Do this one. Do this one. Click this one. This is constraint. So, meaning that you set, okay, 104 from the top, 176 pixel from the left. From right, okay, 49 from text view, okay. Another one. Let me do the same thing, like this, okay. I just want to make it simple, sir. Just design, sir. No need to pay attention. Hey, cannot click. My mouse, eh? Can you see what happened if I drag here? Can you see? Okay. Text number one will depends to the text number two. Okay. When you move this one, okay, when you move this one. The position is not the position of the first tag will be follow the text view. Okay. When you run again. Where is another text view? Let's see. I do the same thing. Sometimes I have to restart. Okay, this one is small thing, yeah. But for the interface, you have to restart from the begin. Here, you have to use run here. Especially if you edit the interface here. Can you see here? This is the text that I want. This is the text view that I want. This is the button that I want. So what happened if I want to make it button is near to the text view number two? Can you see? Can you click the button and shift it to move to the next one, next to move it, up here? I believe you cannot, unless you modify this. Click this one and or this one, okay. From 152 to be 34. Answer. What else? Again. 12. Closer. But I want a closer like this, sir. You click this one again, you modify again. How many times? Agak-agak. How many times you repeat the process here? I wanna, but you if something like this is a static, you know. If you put like this, you limit the movement of the the element of the palette itself. Yeah. So this is this it can be done, but is this not proper way? It work?
Yes, it cannot move if got the constraint.
Mm-hmm. Basically, this is can be proceed, can be run. There is no error, but this is not proper way. The best way is like this. You delete all the constraint first. Can you see? Okay. Click this one. Go to the bottom. Click this one. Go to the top. Can you see the this one? The symbol. It means that you can drag and drop. Sorry, not drag and drop. You can drag this. Okay, move around. Okay. Up to you. But okay. It will be flexible. Let's say I want to make position like this. Okay. The second one, because this one follow the number one, so I let me remove. Cannot anymore. Okay, like this. After that, click this one. And the arrow go down, this one up. Okay, let's see, I make it like this. How about this? I also remove this one. Yeah. Okay. So you can see that this one, let me this one. You can see that the constraint layout here empty, yeah. And you click this one. Hey, oh sorry, this one, not this one. This one. Go to the left. Go to the right. Okay. So how about this? Go to left. Let's go to the right, or maybe little bit here, slightly down. For example, I design like this. Okay. Maybe here. Okay, and then you, if you look at here. Constraint layout, 0, 0, 0. But I want on this position. So let me run. Can you see? This one is better than the previous one. If you want to change the position, this one. Oh, I want a position like this. Huh? For example, maybe this one. It doesn't depend on the others element. Okay, I want display like this. So I run again. Can you see the position not depends to the others, not depend to others. This is the best way. Based on my experience, huh? Sometimes this is simple, but if the student not really pay attention to the design, during the hot, okay, it will you always changing the what we call the constraint layout value, so it take time. Better design like this. Okay. There is no dependency, then you can move up to you, huh? Okay. After that, okay, properties. Yeah. So if you click this one, this is the constraint layout. Okay, and this is the text. text view, you can change the name and be trigger to this one name. Okay, and this is the ID. So what is the important for ID? ID is the identity of this element. So if you want to change, okay, if you want to update this one, okay, for example, this one, let's say I result like this. And ID here is the text view. Maybe I will change the ID result. Result underscore ID. So for example, I want to change the result here, text result, okay, into a certain to other text. So you can recognize the result underscore ID first. Okay, once you get this ID, then you can change the text. So this is the important thing of the ID result. Back to the name here, we still discuss about the layout here. If you look at the below here, there is no there is a layout with layout height. It is totally different, yeah. I mean, this is the same, yeah, wrap content. Wrap content, if you look at this one, this is wrap content. Let me choose another one, text, edit text. Oh, I don't have constraint. Hey, my mouse, yeah? Okay. What happen if I change the layout width here to be match and parent? Okay, or maybe this one. Yeah, this is we call it match constraint or match parent. You can see that I change the where is this? Okay, this one. I change layout width. Match parent, it means that the size of the edit text will match to the parent. The parent here, the whole layout. Okay. Let me check again. What happened? How about the layout height here? I want to check match parent. Can you see the whole layout, the whole layout is name edit text. Let me click again. Maybe this is a wrap content. Wrap the content based on the content itself, the height of the height of the edit text based on the content, yeah, wrap content. Or maybe here I can change into wrap content. That is clear. Layout width and layout height.
Yes, sir.
No question, yeah? Still simple, yeah?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, what else here? The properties. This is important. Okay, especially when you design something, you have to understand layout width and layout height. This one. Okay, let's say I make it empty the text. Okay, next is hint. Hint is used to display, for example, name. You see here, name. So you don't need to this. Maybe I will run so you can see the difference. And you see, this is my text, this is edit text, but inside the edit text, I have name. When I click this one, I can change, D, R, something, but when I remove name, so you can remove this one, text view, then you can only use the, so once you use a hint like this, you can remove this one, this is to be unnecessary. Unless you change this one, for example, it will be personal information. So I put here, this is name. So it will be meaningful compared to the previous one. Okay, clear, hint. What else? I just explain the popular one. Color, for example, text color. Okay, and then this one text size. Okay. You can update here, and then go to the text size. This one. 14 to be 18, for example, textile. Okay, I don't have it. And other thing, okay, you can explore this one. I think that one is the most important. Coloring. Let's see. Let me check the color. Custom. If the background is white, you can change to up to you. Okay. Any question regarding to the design here?
No, sir.
Okay. Can we proceed?
Okay. For the next? Yes.
Sure. Okay.
Next one is about the Java file. Okay. Let's see. This is the UI, and then I wanna type something here, and when I click the trigger button. Then I can display into the this one text view. Yeah. Okay. I go to the main activity. Okay. In this activity, you can type. You can declare the variable private. You example. Okay. Okay. Go to the activity main XML first. Your HTML. When you click this one, split. You can see this one, how many items, how many component inside your layout. How many? Anyone can guess how many component inside the my layout here?
Four.
Okay, when you click this one, it directly go to this one, text view. So this type is text view. Okay, and whatever your design here, it will be converted into XML file, color, highlight, text size. Yeah, this is the ID. Okay, the ID is text view 3. Okay, and this is the name. Okay, name, which is the edit text. Okay, edit text. The ID is edit text text person name to. Okay, let me change. Edit one. For example. Oh, this is edit one. The rest maybe this one I'm not really, because I don't want to update this one personal information, but I want to update this one, okay, which is the result, the and then the ID is result underscore ID, and the input here is the edit text. Let me check the ID again. Edit one. Okay, remember edit one. So you can go to the this one text view, which is the result. Okay, and then private edit text name, for example. So name equal to find view by ID r dot ID dot edit one. Let me explain it to you. First, I declare the private edit text as the edit text name. Name. This is my variable. Okay, variable for my class. Okay. There is no relationship with this one, not yet, yeah, but we try to link it. So in this XML file, the ID is edit text, so means this box yeah, represent the edit text, edit one, and the type is edit text. So in order to link, okay, between the XML file and the Java file, so you can type like this, name. Okay, this is your variable. Okay, so let me give a command. Yeah, this is my variable is name, okay, and then I want to declare as the edit text type, okay, and then I want to find the ID, okay. Find by using this statement, find view by ID r, okay, r means resources, okay. ID r here resources ID edit one, ID edit one, so means that this one. So whatever the value that I enter in this edit one, okay, it will be saved into name. Name here is my local variable. So we have to add a button here. Private. And then here I want to trigger something, button. Result. Set text. Name. dot x to string. Let me try. It worked. Okay, let me explain it to you. Number one is you have to recognize all the elements or the component inside this inside the main activity here. Here there are four components, okay, but not all the components are being used, right? So only three, okay, which is the edit text, yeah, button, and this is the text view. So and the idea here, we wanna fill up this form, okay, name, okay, but once I click this button, it can trigger to edit the text view here. Okay, number one, you have to recognize all of this thing through the XML file. Number one, for example, name. Okay, it goes to the edit text here. You can edit here. For example, Android ID app plus ID slash edit one. So this is the standard. Yeah, standard how to assign the ID in your XML file. Okay, app plus ID slash, and this is the name. Okay. 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 The second one is a button. Okay. When you click the button, try to remember here, what is the ID of the button? Okay. The button ID is the button 2. Okay. Android ID equal to double quote add plus ID slash button 2. Okay, double quote. And another ID is text. So the text itself is result ID. Okay. Okay. After that, go to the Java file number one. Okay. Try to recognize three. Yeah, first is text view. This is for text result. So this is your variable. Yeah, not the XML file. This is your variable in for this class. Okay, and this is your name. Okay. So you need to create a variable, okay? Name. Okay. Okay. This is also your variable, which is the button. Okay. So this variable are used to save. Okay, save the value from the XML file here. In order to link between your Java file to your XML file, okay, you can use find view by ID. Okay, R means resources dot ID. So you are trying to find the resources file that mention ID dot edit one. So it means that this is the variable. Let me take note. Edit one is variable. ID variable in XML. So ID is a variable in XML. Button two also variable in XML. So there are three, yeah. Yeah. After that, you save it into this one button name result. Sir, I don't want to make it like this, sir. Can I put everything here? Can you can type like this, yeah? For example, edit text. If you want to make it like this, fine, no problem. So name here is your variable, but you have to remember, name here is your variable, and this is the one of the edit text, and the result value obtained from the XML file will be saved into name. Okay. Or you can use this way, something like you declare that this is the local variable, okay, because you are declared inside the this class. But if you want to make it public, you can make it public here, same. For example, public. But this is a different name, yeah. If you public, if you define as a public, means that it can be recognized for all function. So the problem is, what happen if you use the same variable? It will be duplicate, and finally redundancy. So you will find the error. Difficult to debug to find the error if you cannot find the error. Okay. Okay. Can you see this one name suddenly? Mention the error, variable name is accessed from within inner class, need to be declared a final. Okay. So if you put here, so you need to declare here again. Edit text. So it can, so the name here can be recognize. So it's better don't use this way, okay? It can be work, but there is a, you have to be careful, especially for declaration. If you want to make it simple, just declare as a private like this, but in outside, not inside like this. So means here name variable in another function here can recognize name. Oh, what's the name? Name is edit text. And the name is used to store the value from the XML file. Okay. Okay, the next one is a button, okay? In order to assign a or trigger button, you can use the button first. Okay, you already link it into the variable button. Then you call button dot set on click listener new view on click listener. So, can you write very fast? You write up very fast. So actually, I use like this. Just type a button, tab, dot, just press dot like this, and then set on click listener. I just tap again. Okay. Here, you have to write new. Okay. Tap again, and then you just press V. Like this. And you see here. View on click listener, just tap it. The Android will write all of this thing. So you don't need to type one by one. The most important thing is you understand what you want to do. Then the Android will suggest it to you, what kind of command that's suitable for you. Okay, after that, here I call the result which is in the XML file, we declare a result ID. Okay, result dot set tag. We set the text. Set text here. If you look at here, click this one. Go to the properties. Can you see text equal to result? So the output here and the appearance here is a result, but under properties text here. Actually, we set the text. Yeah, this is the function. If you want some help, this is a common instruction. Yeah, result dot set text and the value. The value here you can make it directly like this. Okay, name dot get text. Okay, name here is your from the edit one. Okay, save it into name, and then I want to retrieve the properties of name. Yeah, so I can use get text dot to string. We wanna get the string value. Clear? Any question? Open question. 9:30. And this is the result.